All right, the broiler chickens are now 2 weeks old. We're getting ready to enter into week number three with them. And in this video, we're going to talk about the feed that they're on now. We're going to talk about some of the problems that we've had this week. And we're going to talk about some of the misconceptions that people have about raising Cornish Cross chickens. Hey everybody, welcome back to the homestead. This is Kevin with Living Traditions Homestead. You can see the broiler chickens are getting huge. I mean, they have grown a ton in this last week. Now, you remember on my first video, I told you that we always start with one bag of medicated feed. Now, again, that's not an antibiotic. It's an anti-parasite medicine that's in that feed, and it's to help them fight off coccidiosis when they're real tiny. We always do that for the first bag. Just as I had thought, they finished that first bag at, I think it was 10 days old. It's usually right in that 10 or 11 day period that they finished that first bag of feed. So this week, we've now started them on the feed that they'll be on for the rest of their life until it's time to process them. And what we use is a chick grower feed. Now, we buy our feed from a local feed mill, and they don't have a specific broiler ration. What they have is an 18% chick grower. It's a crumble. It's a little bit, finer than like a layer crumble, but not quite as fine as a chick starter. There's no medication in it. It's just a standard 18% feed, and that's what they'll be on now for the rest of their lives. You can see they're very motivated by food. They're eating and drinking really, really well. I haven't weighed them yet because we don't really have a scale like to weigh things that are when they're this small. But I would guess just looking at them that they've almost doubled in size this week. They have just exploded. Remember last week we gave them these bigger feeders. We start them on the real small ones and we went up to these bigger ones last week. They're now going through four of these a day. So, I fill them in the morning, and I fill them again at night, and by the next morning, they're empty again. Same with the water. They're going through at least 4 gallons of water a day, probably a little bit more. So they're definitely progressing to the point where next week, they'll be ready to go out into the tractors. You can see that they're starting to get a lot more of their real feathers. And losing those, baby pin feathers. And I'm just real happy with the way that they're doing. Now, I do have to say, we did lose one more chick this past week. It was actually the same day that I recorded last week's video. And you remember in that video, I had said, they all look healthy. They all look like they were doing so well. And then I came out that afternoon, and there was one dead. And I'm really not sure what caused it. But again, sometimes it's just, weaker ones, and that's part of, raising your own food, is that you can't get too attached to it. You got to keep in your mind that they're not pets. And although you do want to give them, a humane life, and you want to treat them as good as you can, you just can't allow yourself to get too attached to them. But gosh, these guys are doing great. I wanted to talk a little bit about some of the questions that we've received this past week and some of the kind of misconceptions that are out there about the Cornish Cross chickens. One question that I get quite a bit, both online and at the farmer's market, is people asking if the Cornish Cross chickens are genetically modified. They're not. To my knowledge, no genetically modified animals being sold right now. God only knows, but that will probably change at some point in the future. But the best way to think about a Cornish cross chicken is it's a cross between two chickens. Different hatcheries have different ways that they cross the chickens to come up with them, which is why if you order Cornish cross from a few different hatcheries, you'll see differences in how they grow. But my understanding is that normally it's a cross between a Cornish chicken and a Plymouth rock or a Plymouth white chicken. And that's the cross that produces these chickens. It's no different than if you have a dog that's a mutt. This is just they've bred these to grow fast You know, they don't give them hormones. We don't give them hormones. They're just a breed that grows really fast. The other question that we got this week, which I went and did a little more research about afterwards because I wanted to make sure I was answering correctly, was whether or not, you know, you could keep these and have them lay eggs and just produce more Cornish Cross chickens. First of all, these, the answer is absolutely not, because these are all roosters. But if we had hens, the research that I did is there are people who have kept them, and around 6 months old, they will start laying eggs. And actually, they Doug and Stacy from Off Grid with Doug and Stacy have kept some, and they have started to lay eggs. But I've read several blogs where people have done that. I think Ozark Off Grid family has also done that as well. But nowhere have I read that anybody was able to hatch the eggs, because from what I read, their roosters were not interested at all in mating with the Cornish Cross chickens. I didn't see anybody reporting any success with being able to breed their own and come up with something that was the same. The way I guess I think about that is, even if you were able to get them to breed, and I'm sure if you do enough research, you know, I didn't do a ton, there's probably someone out there who has gotten that to work. But it's kind of like seed saving out of your garden. If you have a hybrid tomato plant, which is really the cross of a couple tomato plants, and then you save the seeds from that tomato and try to grow them the next year, yes, you'll get a tomato plant, and you'll probably get tomatoes, but it's not going to be the same as the tomato that you saved those seeds from. That would be the same with these guys. If you bred them, even if you could get a chick, it wouldn't be a Cornish Cross chick. It would be just another mixed breed. So those are just some of the questions that we've gotten this week. I hope that clears up a little bit about what these guys are. You know, they're not genetically modified. They are just a breed that grows really, really fast. And, you know, another thing that, you know, I hear a lot of people talking about is how, you know, it's kind of cruel to raise these guys because, you know, they grow so fast that they're, you know, by the time they get to butcher age, you know, they can't walk. Their legs give out, they're dying of heart attacks, you know, they're just miserable. And you'll see as we progress through this series that in our experience that's simply not true. We have raised now close to 1,000 of these. I've only one time had one whose leg was deformed so much that he couldn't walk. And honestly, that bird had a deformed leg from the time we got it as a day-old chick. Other than that, we've never had them get to the point where they can't walk. We've never had them, you know, just fall over from heart attacks. And a lot of that, I would say, if you're having those problems, if you tried raising these and you're having those problems, it's probably because you're feeding them incorrectly. You'll see starting next week when we move them out into the chicken tractors that we start feeding them 12 hours on and 12 hours off. We'll give them their food every morning at 7 a.m. and we'll take it away every night at 7 p.m. And the reason that we do that is to slow down their growth. If you were to feed these guys around the clock for the entire 8 weeks, they probably would grow too fast and they would have a lot more health issues. You need to do 12 hours on, 12 hours off. And that will slow down the growth enough that you'll have healthy chickens all the way through the 8 weeks. Last night we actually broke a record low for September. It got down to 48 degrees, which is really cold here for September. So I did turn their lights back on last night. But other than that, I'm now leaving their lights off all the time during the day. It's been in the mid to upper 70s, which is plenty warm for these guys. Even at 2 weeks old, there's, you know, you want to encourage them to start getting the feathers and be able to regulate their own heat. So that's it. You can see that they're doing well. They're eating and they're running all around. And, you know, next week is the big week. Next week's the week we move them out into the tractors. The week that we give them their bigger feeders so they can, you know, have all the feed that they want for that 12 hours. And we'll give them some new waterers next week as well, and I'll show you how to make those. So that's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button so that you get all of the updates and you can follow along with this series. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and a comment. If you have any questions for me, leave those below. And until next time, you guys, thanks so much for stopping by the homestead, and God bless.